east coast of China for the Thai Hot China Open, the 11th of the 12 tournaments that make up the MetLife BWF World Super Series. There you can see the full list. Now, not only is the China Open the 11th event, but it's also the last of the five premier events, an even higher tier of tournament within the Super Series. So just Hong Kong and the Destination Dubai Super Series finals to come. Well, five matches for you this afternoon, and we're starting with men's singles and a repeat of the French Open final. The champion in Paris, Li Chongwei, against Chao Tien Chen. Then women's singles and the beaten finalists from the last two Super Series. The beaten finalists in Denmark, PV Sindhu, up against the beaten finalists from Paris, Wang Shexian. Then men's singles and brief Lebedev of France takes on the five-time champion here at the China Open. The Olympic champion as well, of course, Lin Dan. Then men's doubles and Kai Yun and Liu Kai up against Endo and Hawakawa, bronze medalists at this year's World Championships. And then we've turned to women's doubles and the silver medalists from the World Championships, Peterson and Rutiul, up against the bronze medalists from the recent World Championships, Fukuman and Yonao. So some great matches for you this afternoon. And the first of those is the former world number one, Li Chongwei of Malaysia, against Chao Tien Chen of Chinese Taipei. Well, before we get play underway, a chance for us to look at the Destination Dubai standings at the moment in the men's singles. And I can tell you, in that list, seven players changing places. The top two remain the same, and that's not surprising when you consider that Chen Long and Momota, between them, have won seven of the 10 Super Series events so far this year. Well, Li Chongwei and Chao Tien Chen. Chao Tien Chen actually moved up a place on this recent Destination Dubai rankings. He went up above Lin Dan, so after reaching the final in Paris. So, the toss of the coin by our umpire. His first duty, Li Sen of China. Her Shuang Ying, our service judge. Well, there is the former world number one, Li Chongwei. Twice he's reached the final here at the China Open. You have to go back to 2007 and 2008. In both of those finals, he lost to Chinese left-handers. Bao Chun Lai was one of them, and Lin Dan was the other. But here is the 25-year-old from Taipei, number six seed, down one place in the world ranking this week to number seven. He has been as high as five. And last year, he was a semi-finalist here, losing out in the semi-final to Lin Dan, who then lost in the final. Well, two finals this year from 17 tournaments played for Chao Tien Chen. Reached the final of his home Grand Prix gold event, Chinese Taipei. Here, Li Chongwei, not seeded. He's up one place in the world ranking this week, up to number nine. But of course, he has been world number one. The 33-year-old turned 33 last month from Georgetown in Penang. Well, I can tell you that whilst we look at the head-to-head, and that, of course, was the French Open final that I was telling you about, which was the last Super Series prior to this China Open, and Li Chongwei won in two straight games. Now, we really ought to mention the fact that these two players have played one match already to get through to this second round encounter, and Li Chongwei beat the winner of the Bitburger Grand Prix gold, Ng Kar Long from Hong Kong, in two straight games. This man, Chao Tien Chen, had a much harder match yesterday against Xue Song. Dropped the opening game, 12-21, then won 21-15, 21-17. I'm Jill Clark, and delighted to say that I have former Danish head coach Steen Petersen joining me once more. Missed you on the last couple of tournaments, Steen, but I know that, although you weren't in Paris, you got a chance to watch that match, and of course Li Chongwei was way in front in that second game, and then there was a bit of a comeback from Chow Tien Chen, wasn't it? So it made it a very close looking score, but it, in reality it was a little one-sided.
Yeah, I used to call it garbage time when the game is actually decided, but you have still have a chance to score some points. Interesting to see the rematch here.
And on my left, Li Chongwei, Malaysia. Li Chongwei to serve. Lawo, play.
So Li Chongwei, former world number one, and twice a finalist here at the China Open. Well, he looks as if he means business, doesn't he? It was interesting, Steen. I came down to the stadium on the players' bus, and both of the players on the bus, and both very chatty with me, and both saying hello, and they both looked very relaxed. And certainly Chow Tien Chen was indicating that now he's had a bit of a rest, he hopes to do a bit better today.
Yeah, I was actually a little surprised.
Missed how it.
Yeah, just wide.
So that's all.
A little surprised on how easy it was for Chongwei to win in Paris. I think Chow Tien Chen has improved a lot. And
yes.
It's interesting to see whether it makes any difference that we're playing in a very, very big hole here in Fuzhou compared to the much smaller Stade de Pierre de Coubertin in Paris.
Mm. Just explain that a little bit more. How would that be different for the players then?
Normally, with the smaller stadiums, it favors the attacking players or the players that play a very precise, very accurate game. Whereas the bigger stadiums, it's a little bit difficult to get the timing right, especially in the earlier rounds of the tournament. And that's why it's a little bit harder for the more attacking players to get it their game going in the first rounds. But then again, we know that both these two players can definitely attack.
Yeah. Oh yes, that's nice. It's interesting you say about Chow Tien Chen and his improvement. The last four Super Series, he's been in at least a semi-final of all four. And I can remember chatting to him earlier in the year. Oh, that's delightful. And he was telling me that he had listened to some of our commentaries. And we had been a little critical of him taking the shuttle a bit late at the net. And he said that he's really tried to work on that. He's been talking to his coach. He's been working on other aspects of his game. And, of course, we're acutely aware he, by his standards, had a disastrous World Championships. He was seeded, lost in the first round. But I think so many players could learn from him because he's been prepared to work on his game. In the interim period, you take a step backwards before the possibility of taking three, two, three, or maybe even four steps further forward. And he has improved.
Yeah, and that's what so many players find hard, that when you have to make major changes in your game, you have to accept a decrease in form.
Yeah,
it's simply natural that if you try to do something that you haven't done earlier, then you're not very good at it in the beginning.
Oh yes. Well, I have to say that I thought Li Chongwei in Paris was the Li Chongwei of old. We've seen him in recent tournaments. It's been well documented. He's had a crisis in confidence by losing in the qualifying in Korea. You know, that's one result. You don't become a bad player overnight. He's still a great badminton player.
And I think actually it's exactly the case that we just discussed with Chow, that he was making changes in his game. And I think the same goes for Li Chongwei. And that's why it's so great to see him back to winning ways in Paris. Of course, being perhaps the
look at that!
Yeah, great play.
Oh, the clear is just long. Sorry to interrupt you, Steve.
Yeah, he's definitely the best bid for a Malaysian medal at the Olympics, and of course, there's a lot of people interested in him doing well, and sometimes that can create some confusion.
Mm. And certainly pressure.
Yeah.
This is a good rally. Oh, good bounty smash. Oh, he's overdone it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Seven, four.
And this is perhaps one of the situations where Charles still can improve a little bit. So, Charles, if you're listening.
he'll listen back, all right.
Later on, when the rallies get long, in the game that is not clearly a defensive game for Chow, or clearly an offensive game for him, then how do you actually conduct yourself in that situation? The patience needed, the small changes in shot placement in order to create an opportunity for yourself, and that's something that takes experience to figure that out.
Yeah.
So important for singles players to use that cross smash from their forehand side in order to sort of keep the opponents guessing. It's not so easy because you open up all your backhand side if the opponent reaches that smash.
Mm. Oh, look at that. Look at that.
9-4.
And I'm really looking forward to see Lee Chong Wei in this tournament because I'm watching his shot quality. I've criticized him earlier for making some loose shots that he can get away with, or he normally could get away with, but he definitely needs to improve on that, and I think he has done that.
I thought that the turning point was his second round match against Victor Axelsen in Paris, and I thought after that, I thought Lee Chong Wei, do you remember how he used to just ooze confidence on court? With every shuttle he struck, he looked as if he was just in complete control. I was beginning to see that again.
Yeah. And here we can see
11, 4,
when we go to the interval, we can see that his lobs are a bit more flat than we've seen at some times.
Mm. From the net, you mean the lifts?
Yeah, the lifts. Okay.
Yeah. Okay, so if you were talking to Chow Tien Chen right now, what would you be saying?
Yeah, that's a good question. I'm not really sure what I would be saying because right now Chong Wei is in control. I think he needs to up the pace in the rally, but then again, to up the pace against Chong Wei is also difficult. So maybe it's actually a change of pace in the middle of the rally, see if something good happens. If it doesn't, then back off a little bit again and play.
Just concentrate on moving
the
shuttle. And so a bit of injection with of pace of shot and pace of movement.
And then if nothing good happens and the chances doesn't get bigger, then go back to being patient, but play with a good shot quality. We saw in Denmark Open, we saw Wei Nan from Hong Kong being extremely successful in using his steep smashes that sort of lands 50 centimeters closer to the net compared to normal smashes. And Chong Wei were having trouble reaching those smashes. So, but right now he's totally in control.
Oh, behind the back, tried a bit of trickery. Now, that presumably is the sort of thing you wanted to see from Chow Tien Chen. Take that half chance at the net. Look at that.
He's playing well, Chung Wei.
He is, isn't he?
And he's not giving Chow any extra time. And I felt that at some point after his comeback, he was sort of playing a little bit too passive on the lifts and on the net shots and so on.
I thought he was too passive in general.
Yeah.
I mean, we're seeing that explosive willingness to dictate the pace and go for winners now that we didn't see early on in his comeback.
Yeah.
That's nice.
So that's all. 6-13.
And for a period, we also saw some very high clears from Chung Wei, where he sort of backed off and said, okay, I don't really have a plan, so let's see what you're going to do, and then I'll see if I can counterattack. But now it seems like he has more of a plan in his game, that he wants to try to control the rallies. And if he's a little bit in control, he wants to make that chance bigger and bigger. Until it's actually winnable through smashes or kills.
Let's look at that. Brilliant.
That's well played.
What a rally from Lee Chong Wei.
15-6.
And you can't see whether it's straight or cross.
No.
So it's impossible to cover both sides. You have to be guessing a little bit. Later on today in the third match, we're going to see Lin Dan, and when he gets a little bit time in his forehand, it's exactly the same. You simply cannot see whether it's a straight or a cross smash.
Yeah.
16-6.
Well, you were talking about those little hold and flicks, weren't you?
Yeah.
This was... Oh, gosh, he held that shot to the last moment, didn't he? And this is now 10 of the last 12 points to Lee Chong Wei.
And it's okay that they're in the game. They just can't be exaggerated, these deceptions.
Yeah.
So.
I think if I were Chow, I'd go more all out on the attack and test the defense of Chong Wei. It was the part of his game that, in my opinion, suffered the most from his 8-month ban. But the good thing here, or the clever thing from Chung Wei, is that he don't give the big chances away.
Yeah.
He did that earlier, but that's been erased from his game. And that means that his defense is actually much better now.
Yes, Coach Tosu Bok still looking a little twitchy at the back of the court there.
Yeah.
Still not fully relaxed. And you with a 10-point advantage.
Interesting that it's Tosu Bok. Are there any other Malaysian men's singles players in this tournament?
I don't think so.
No, because that was a discussion, at least in the newspapers, that Chung Wei needed someone to spar with during the Japan and Korea Open. And Tosu Bok is a fantastic feeder.
Multi-feeds.
Multi-feeds, yeah.
Yeah. I gather Morten Frost is in Brazil at the moment, looking for a suitable training camp for the Malaysian badminton players during the Olympics or prior to the Olympics. That's lovely. That is inch perfect.
So that's all. 8-17.
Oh my goodness, that's good. Ah, now that was good from Chao Tien-chen. He read that cross-court shot.
Yeah.
And that's what you were talking about, that if your opponent does get that back, then you have
a long run.
You have a long run.
Yeah.
Full diagonal of the court to scamper. It's landed in.
So there's Sova. 18-9.
Misjudgment from Chao Tien-chen, but excellent placement from Lee Chong-wei. I think that's, you know, I know he's made the error, and most coaches would say can't be affording to make errors, but I like the fact that he was going for that steep angle, because that's what you were talking about earlier about Wei Nan when he played against Lee Chong Wei and how effective that was. So the more he can get in the range of those little angled shots before the start of the second game, the better.
Yeah.
20 game point 9.
So a whole host of game point opportunities for Lee Chong Wei.
Game. First game won by Lee Chong Wei, 21-9.
It seems like he was a little bit out of ideas, Chong, even though he tried some shots here, but I don't see it as part of a new plan or anything. Interesting to see here in the second game.
Yes, our opening game, 21-9 in just 18 minutes. His whole demeanour, Lee Chong Wei, is much more relaxed now. It's amazing what one tournament win can do for a player's confidence.
Yeah, and it's also when you're making these small changes to your game, then in the beginning you're uncertain and you can't really see how it fits in, and then suddenly when you experience success, then you get even more confident because you know that, oh, what I've been working on is actually helping me in tournaments, and then it's so easy to do more of it. So if you actually have that attitude in the beginning, then it will go quicker. If you realize that there's going to be some bumps on the way.
Yeah.
Court 1, 20 seconds. Court 1, 20 seconds.
Of course, we shouldn't get ahead of ourselves, but if both Lee Chong Wei and Lin Dan wins their matches today, we have a fantastic matchup tomorrow, and that could be really, really interesting.
I think you're one day ahead of yourself.
I'm one day ahead. That was what we shouldn't do. It was only in the semifinals that they were to meet.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So one game to the good, Lee Chong Wei. 21-9, that opening game. Oh, now. That's what you were looking for in the opening game.
Tried to put pressure on Chong Wei's defense and see how good it is. But the difficult thing is you need to have some kind of chances. And we haven't seen a lot of chances like this where Chong had the required time.
So.
Yes. Oh, you're absolutely right. I see your point completely.
Two, one.
But the number of times I watch Chow Tien Chen, and I think he's sometimes a bit of a slow starter, and he makes matches more difficult for himself. Of course, yesterday against Xue Song, dropped the opening game.
Yeah.
And then seemed to be a different player in the second and third. Yeah, look at that.
Perhaps also realizing that, I tried to do it another way in the first game. I tried to do it perhaps in a little easier way, and I'm perhaps a little bit afraid of the defense of Chong Wei, or at least the speed of Chong Wei. But realizing that, hey, I got to do it this way. It's probably going to be hard, but that's the only chance I have for success in this match. In other matches, we've seen that his defense, Chou's defense, has improved a lot. I just don't think he can beat Chong Wei by playing a defensive style. Oh, he should have tapped that one.
Yeah.
Well played.
Yeah, cost him dear. Because that gave the opportunity for that deceptive drop from Lee Chong Wei. Well, a year ago when Chow Tien Chen lost in the semi-final to Lin Dan, that ended a 14-match winning streak. Because, of course, Chow Tien Chen had won the French Super Series and followed that up by winning his third consecutive Bitburger Grand Prix gold. I mean, that was a phenomenal run, wasn't it? Unseeded, won the French Open a year ago. Chow Tien Chen really marked his breakthrough, I think, in world terms. That's a great lift. Smash. Oh, yeah. Altogether more fired up now, Chow Tien Chen.
And that push to the backhand, that sort of gave him the loose shot from Chong Wei that was a little bit too short, and he was able to punish him. Another one there, but he just missed it.
Oh, that's brilliant. Oi. Oh, my goodness. Oh. I can assure you that Steen and I are sitting up in right in the top tiers of this magnificent stadium, and there's no way that Chow Tien Chen could have heard us. But he is doing exactly what you suggested.
Yeah. Question is, can he keep up? Well played there by Chong Wei, because it's a very physically demanding playing style, and I think Chong Wei is doing his best to always stay in balance, and that's of course a very good plan to have.
Yeah, the shuttle got deflected on the attempted lift there from Chow Tien Chen. over committing forward.
That's wide.
Yeah.
Service over. 6-0.
He was telling me that when he was a youngster, he used to get up at some unearthly hour in the morning to go training Chao Tianchen. Then he'd go off to school, and then he would come back and then go training again. And then he would go to night school to learn English.
Wow.
And then get up again the next morning and start his training again. And he does speak very good English. He's a charming young man.
That's a loose shot.
7-6.
Now that's the shot that you were talking about when he was going through that is his sort of bad patch as he was coming back. Yeah.
That was better. You saw the way he started?
Yeah.
It was like he was coming out of the blocks on 100 meter.
Yeah. Inch perfect.
7-8.
Yeah, and the cross smashes we've seen from his forehand, Li Chongwei, keeps the court open for his straight smashes. What a great straight smash there from Chao. But that that flicker from Chao and the straight smash from Chongwei that we had the rally before that, I don't think he could do anything else than play it straight. But it's hard for Chao to judge.
Mm.
So. 8-9.
Now, I know he made a mistake, but look at the difference to about a year ago on where Chao is trying to take that net shot.
Yeah.
Much better, isn't it?
And it's the only way to do it is to be there and to make some mistakes and figure out, okay, I might have needed to stay a bit closer, that one, so I get the lift.
Oh, that's brilliant from Chongwei. Oh, my goodness. There's a couple he's been undecided on the back. Oh! What a rally. Oh, it had a little think about it, but stayed Chao Tianchen's side of the net.
Mapping.
Well, Li Chongwei also indicating to the umpire that the court needs to be mopped, his side of the court as well.
Yeah, and it really should be automatic that when one mopper is coming onto court, the other one goes in as well, just to check if he or she is needed on court.
Mm.
Make sure that... the play is continuous.
What a good return of serve. Yeah.
So that's all. 10-0.
So who's going to have the advantage at the mid-game interval? This point will decide it.
loose shot again.
11, yeah.
So it is Chow Tien Chen, number 16 Lanta. From Chinese Taipei, has a 1-point advantage here at the mid-game interval. Well, just turned 33, but you'd never know it, would you, in the way he's moving and the way he's playing.
No, he's still so quick on his feet.
Yeah. And it really annoys, well, it certainly did when I was a player and I reached the big 3-0 and everybody sort of felt that was it. I was a goner.
Court 1, 20 seconds. Court 1, 20 seconds.
Yeah, it will be interesting to see some results of his weight and muscular weight development throughout his career. I know that the Danish men's singles players tend to gain like 6 to 8 kilos of muscles throughout a career.
Wow. There's another loose routine.
Yeah.
Now, I mean, you've already pointed out three.
Yeah. So the service returns needs to be better.
Mm.
Still, I also feel that the flat game from Li Chengwei, when he's been put under pressure, especially in his backhand side, there's still some issues there. And I'm imagining, what if it was Chen Long on the other side here? I guess he would sort of take a little bit of the power off his smashes in order to be in better balance and be able to move quicker to the front court, because all the pickups from Chengwei is going to the front court.
Unbelievable net exchange. Good rally.
Yeah.
Brilliant! Terrific rally.
14, 10.
Very comforting for Chou Tianchen, because this was one of the rallies where earlier in the match he looked a little bit like he didn't really know what to how to proceed when the first attack didn't succeed and he survived the defense then. What do I do? This one was much better.
So that's all. 11. 14.
Just sensed, Dean, that the next 3 or 4 points are really important.
Yeah. Oi.
So that's so. 15, 11.
Oh, this is great badminton. Oh!
Oi. Fantastic touch there.
Yeah, looks as if it surprised Taesu Bock as well. Look at this control. Racket head just taking the pace out of the shot. Amazing.
He was there, Chong Wei, but it was impossible to return.
That is fabulous control at the front of the court. Right, Li Chong Wei standing his ground, and yet look at that night shot from Zhao Tianchen.
It's wide.
Oh, yeah. He read that, didn't he?
I was just thinking about that, not exactly that shot, but when he's having his attacking chances, Chow, maybe once in a while an attacking clear would be wise as the first shot instead of always attacking on the first chance. That's a good call.
14-17.
Way too short, that one. Yeah. Well played by Chow.
Solid. 18-14.
And I think before the ban of Chong Wei, there was quite a big gap between Chong Wei, Chen Long, Lin Dan, and the persuaders, but that gap is definitely closed.
Beginning of that rally, there was a round the head smash from Chow Tianchen. I think he jumped from his base position. Oh, that's good judgment, isn't it? My goodness me. That's an interesting comment, you know, Steen. I totally agree with you. It was either Lin Dan, Li Chong Wei, or Chen Long that was winning all the big events. And I don't know. I mean, it's going through my mind. Is it because the top three, especially the two past the big 3-0, Li Chong Wei and Lin Dan, that, you know, now they're in their 30s, have they slowed down slightly?
Yeah.
Or is it that the chasing pack have all improved? And I think it's probably a combination of the two.
Yeah, I agree.
Well, one thing's for certain, Chow Tianchen is 2 points away from taking this second game. Make that one point away.
Game point 14.
And Chong Wei is not getting the game going the way he did in the first game. He's not able to stay in control. That's it. Very nice shot. Oh, that's beautiful. That was the clear I talked about before.
15-20.
Yeah, that attacking clear. Instead of going for all attacking shots, that throw in the attacking clear.
Yes, so that Chong Wei won't know that he only has to concentrate on the front court whenever Chow has the chance. Great pick up there. Oh,
what an unbelievable block there from Chow Tianchen. 21-15, 41 minutes into the match, and we will be treated to a third and deciding game. What a great comeback by Chow Tianchen after that drubbing in the opening game by Li Chong Wei. Li Chong Wei taking a new shirt. I'm not surprised. It's quite warm conditions here in Fuzhou. Yeah, both going to have a change of shirts. Perspiration making the shirts sopping.
And actually quite good playing conditions, because I don't think there's a lot of drift. I haven't been able to pick up on it so far. I talked to some of the Danish players, and they said that there was a little drift in one of the outer courts and so on. But definitely no need for air conditioning right now. So it's just the normal drift of a big stadium that would influence the play.
Yeah. Okay, so let's reverse things. I was asking you between the first and second game what you would be saying to Chiao Tianchen. What would you be saying to Li Chongwei now that you've won the opening game, you've cruised the opening game, and all of a sudden you're faced with playing a decider?
So the easy thing is just let's get back to where we started and play another first game. But it's a little bit harder now because Chao has definitely adjusted his game. So Chongwei needs to do that as well, and probably needs to play a little bit more attacking, not to try to win directly from the attack, but to prevent Chao from getting the attack. And I think he needs to do that, and he needs to get rid of the loose shots on the service returns. And I still have a question mark in his in his backhand, which I think is possible to put pressure on. Well played. Oh, he was waiting. Chongwei.
One, low.
It's also that we've been, so at least I've been sighing for someone to close this gap between the top three players and the rest for a number of years. And now it seems like it's about to close. We see Chen Long; he's been good when it matters. But it also shows how dominant Lin Dan has been throughout his career, because all the players chasing these top three, they're looking at them and saying, "Hey, how do we get to beat one of those players? What do we need to practice?" And that's why it's so hard staying on top for such a long period as we've seen Lin Dan do.
Yeah. But also, in fairness, Li Chongwei, I know Lin Dan has won world titles and Olympic gold medals, whereas Li Chongwei has medals, but not the gold.
Yeah.
But, I mean, Li Chongwei's record is phenomenal. He's been in 89 career finals, winning 58 of them. 39 Super Series titles. Now, I gave Duff information when I was in Paris. I thought he'd won his 40th. And the reason I got confused was because the 2010 Super Series finals were played in 2011.
I thought so, Jill. I noticed that back home, and I thought, I think she's got that one wrong.
So I do apologize about my error there and my confusion. I had him down for winning the 2011 Super Series finals, but it wasn't the case. It was the 2010 Super Series finals played in January 2011. Yeah. But yes, his record is phenomenal. And I think this tournament a year ago was part of the catalyst to make the rest of the players, the chasing pack, believe. Because a year ago, Lin Dan in the final against the unseeded Srikanth Kidambi, and Srikanth won last year. And incidentally, as defending champion, he lost first round yesterday. Srikanth just missed it. And I think that was very similar to Tina Baun winning the Japan Open in 2007 as an unseeded player, and she beat five Chinese-born players back-to-back. One was then representing Germany. But, you know, all of a sudden there was a belief that from the women's singles players...
Gave the others hope.
Yes, we can beat these top Chinese players. And I think this tournament last year was part of the catalyst now for all the other players believing. Instead of playing the reputation of Li Chongwei or Lin Dan and even Chen Long, they're playing the man.
Exactly. Oh, that's very nice.
Oh, there's a challenge.
Pick up there, I think it was in.
Challenge caught in.
Well, first challenge of the match. Oh. Oh, difficult to tell. Now, I thought initially it was going to go wide. I wonder if there's a bit of a sideways drift. Did the Danish badminton players talk about that?
They didn't talk about it, but I think from seeing the players warming up, I would suggest.
You thought that on the warm up. Yeah. Well, that's clearly in.
A little bit of a drift from left to right, as we see it in the picture here.
Challenge unsuccessful. One challenge remain. 4-3. Play.
Oh, this is fascinating stuff. It's not just about ability in sport, it's also about character. Who can handle the pressure? Who can play the big points well? Oh, yes, the key there, taking it early from Lee Chong Wei. When you come from above the shuttle at the front of the court, you've got so many options.
Well played, well played.
Yeah, it was that sort of half smash, first of all.
Yes, I love that smash.
Yeah. This one. Going for placement, an angle, forces the short lift, and then the opportunity to play the winner. That's brilliant.
Yeah, and if he picks up short Chow, then Chong Wei is still able to reach it early at the net and put pressure on him on the next shot.
Oh my goodness! Oh! Wow, that was incredible.
7-4, 4-7.
Well, it just shows how tight these net shots have got to be. Look at this. Takes it off the top of the tape.
Yeah. Nothing to say about that. Just a little bit unlucky that it was such a tight shot from Chow. But a lot of psychology in that as well. To show your opponent that you're there, you're ready to kill it if it's a little bit too high. Cannot let the opponent win the net.
Oh, look at that, that's nice. Good rally. Oh my goodness.
Yeah.
Well, badminton at its very best.
This time we saw Chow with a loose backhand shot there, and I'm wondering if there's a slight drift anyway here. It seems like the player playing on the side closest to the camera is having trouble getting the correct length on his shots. So what I'm suggesting is that there might be a little bit drift from Chao Tianchen towards Li Chengwei, but if there is, it's definitely not much.
No. Well, you can clearly see that the court hasn't been mopped properly. Still wet patches there. Yeah, Li Chengwei. Well, not often that you see his emotions change on court. It was lovely to see him so delighted with his win in Paris. Oh, that's perfect length. Perfect.
Very good lift.
Oh. Yeah. You know, before his suspension, Steen, we're talking about records here. Li Chengwei only twice failed to reach the final of a Premier Super Series tournament played.
That's amazing.
Came in 2011. Yeah. And all top 10 players have to play all Premiers.
Yeah, yeah. So he so rarely lost to other players than Lin Dan and Chen Long.
Yeah. Important for Chao Tianchen, because by my reckoning, Li Chengwei had just won 9 of the last 10 points. Was it 3-1 to Chao Tianchen at one stage?
I think 2-all, but I'm not sure.
Ah, beg your pardon. Yeah, we're struggling with internet here. We can't follow it. We're doing it by memory, aren't we? Gone long.
6-10.
Yeah, this is important. Get the score as close as possible before playing the end, where both players have played better. Oh yes, superb. That's is Li Chengwei back to his old self.
And he stands there, just stays at the net. He knows he's so fast moving backwards.
Yes, and he knows he's played the shuttle so tight to the net that it's got to be a very high lift. For even more time to get back.
Court 1, 20 seconds.
This match in progress, 55 minutes. Well, Chao Tianchen, he's enjoyed victories this year over Lin Dan, who's currently number 3 in the world, Jano Jorgensen, who's currently number 2 in the world. So he can draw on that experience and that belief. Did find it extraordinary that prior to the French Open final, these two had never met each other in international competition. Oh, string's gone in the racket. Because they've both been playing on the circuit for some time now.
Yeah, but I guess it was last season that Chow really made a move. Getting into the quarterfinals, semifinals on a regular basis. But still, would have thought the draw would once in a while pair them against each other. Seems like he doesn't really believe in his shot there.
Well, I was just about to say, I wonder if that's one of your theories on the provoked shot. I can remember you saying just a moment or two ago that Lee Chong-wei was there and he was sending a psychological message to his opponent. Yeah. If you pay no heed to the net, I'm ready to pounce.
But I've seen him be a little bit too quick to move away from his forehand side, Chow, earlier in this match, and I think he doesn't really finish his shot at the net before he's on his way backwards, looking for the attacking opportunity.
Just on the forehand side.
Yeah, on the forehand net shot.
Oh, look at that!
Because it's a more difficult movement backwards from the from the forehand side.
Yeah.
There's no problem there. Yeah, there is some a little problem anyway, but this match is slipping away from him now.
Oh! Oh, would you believe it? Well, Tae-Soo Bok can see the funny side. I'm not sure that Lee Chong-wei so amused. Goodness me, what an exchange. Look at this. Net cord takes it off at the top of the tape. Lee Chong-wei's there. Has the simple opportunity to play the winner. The strings go in the racket. Look at that.
Yeah, very odd that the string broke. It must have been this saving shot from Chong-wei. So when he suddenly got the opportunity, he wasn't really aware that one of the strings had gone.
So that's all. 16-7.
Oh, it was going wide.
I agree. Good shot.
What a good rally. Yeah, there was the punch clear.
Yeah.
Yeah, and it drew the error.
So that's so. 8-16.
Simply have to have variation in your game nowadays. The players and coaches, they have so much information, so much video material. I just spoke to one of the, not one of them, but the Danish video operator, and he'd been up until 4 o'clock this morning tagging matches. So you simply tag the server situation, and the computer program takes 1 second before and 2 seconds after, so you know what kind of shots are coming. Tag the attacking situations and the defense situations and so on, so you can get all the services from the left field of the court and see the different kind of returns, see what the probability are for the different corners.
Oh, that's well played.
16.
Yeah, very well played. Three straight points.
Seven.
pushed it long.
Yeah. And this is from a Malaysian perspective. I'm pretty sure Li Chun Wei is going to win this match now. But if I were Tae Shui Bok, I would only be satisfied if it's like 21-12 or something like that. If it's 15, then it's too much. He's been taking his foot off the pedal too much.
So and so. 11, 17.
Oh, that's a good return.
Mm.
So and so. 18, 11.
Oh, yeah. Indecision.
19, 11.
Oh my goodness me, that is superb.
Point, match point 11.
Yep. 9 match point opportunities for Li Chun Wei. Serve is long. And Li Chun Wei is through to the quarter final of the China Open. 21-9, 15-21, 21-12 in the deciding game. An hour and 4 minutes. Yeah, and I thought that was impressive from the former world number one, Li Chun Wei. So too from Chao Tianchen, because the way he played in that second game, I think perhaps physically he just couldn't sustain that sort of pace of shot and pace of movement that he showed in that second game. So victory to Li Chun Wei in the 3 games, 21-12 in the deciding game. The first of our matches complete, and what an excellent match it was. Next up, we've got women's singles and the beaten finalists from the last two Super Series events. Then we're back to men's singles and the five-time champion here, Lin Dan, in action against Brice Lavadez of France. Then men's doubles and Tai Yun and Liu Kai. Tai Yun, incidentally, has never won the China Open. That's an astonishing statistic considering his years with Fu Haifeng. This is probably one of the few major tournaments that Tai Yun and Fu Haifeng never won. And as you saw after that men's doubles, we'll have women's doubles and world championship silver medalists against world championship bronze medalists. But first, we've got women's singles. Pusala Venkata Sindhu of India against Wang Shexian, the number 5 seed from China. Well, these two players have played each other many times before. Today will be the 8th meeting between the two. So they'll know each other's games very well indeed. Wang Shexian is, of course, number 1 currently on the Destination Dubai Super Series rankings, having been beaten finalist in Paris. Remained at number 1. 2 finals she's been in this year. Australian Open as well. The winner from Paris is currently at number 2, and you may be wondering how, when she's won 4 Super Series titles this year, she's number 2. There she is. Well, I wonder the same thing. She's only played one less tournament. The only change was Sung Ji Hyung and Tai Su Ying swapped positions, but here's an interesting stats. All 10 players on the list there have all been in a Super Series tournament final this year. Such is the competition. That really backs up what we were saying earlier as well, doesn't it, Steen, about strength in depth now, how the chasing pack, certainly in men's singles and women's singles, it's been happening for a couple of years now. Only player who's won a Super Series tournament, Steen, that's not on that list in the women's singles?
Oh, that's a difficult one.